accused of.
Accused is not found guilty.
I want to know.
Just because I don't go to church every time the doors are open doesn't mean I don't believe. And God doesn't expect us to be perfect, but he does expect us to try and repent of our sins.
He's not my choice. I'm not voting for him because I like him. I'm voting for him because I don't want Doug Jones. But Roy Moore is entitled to the presumption of innocence in the law and in the Bible, just like anybody else should be. They're only accusations. There have been no charges filed. All you have is a group of women that have come forward
how
and
many?
Said...
How many?
Seven.
More.
No, there's really three.
Higher. How many women have to come forward before you say, wait a minute, where there's smoke, there's fire?
It's a matter of legitimacy, not just how many.
Exactly.
How many are actually not being paid or being coerced to do that?
How many of them do you think are being paid?
All of them.
All of them?
Yeah. All of them.
By show of hands, how many of you think all the women are being paid? Seriously.
To me, there are only two women that maybe have a smoking gun, but, you know, the women's their reputations were questionable at the time.
Is this how you want to be treated as a woman if something were to happen to you? Do you want to be dismissed that way?
Better have proof.
You know, it doesn't sound like it went beyond there were still clothes on. It doesn't sound like it went beyond anything. And that as soon as the girl said she wasn't comfortable, he took her home.
I guess my question is, you blame her. She's 14.
I'm not blaming her. I'm blaming both of them. So I didn't say that I thought he was without sin. It's possible he did it, but it's possible that he could be forgiven for... I don't think he raped her.
Let's be real. It was a different world. 40 years ago in Alabama, people could get married at 13 and 14 years old. My grandmother at 13 was married at 15, had two children and a husband and a job. If Roy Moore was guilty, if he was at the mall hitting on this 14-year-old, 40 years ago in Alabama, there's a lot of mamas and daddies that'd be thrilled that their 14-year-old was getting hit on by a district attorney.
I dated an older man at 16, so we don't really...
How old was he?
31. I'm not going to say that the 14-year-old, that's... I don't believe her, to be honest. The one that said she was 14, I don't believe her. But for all of us, as a woman, I think we've pretty much all been in the situation where there's been a sexual harassment.
I mean, think about what you're saying. You're calling all nine of those women liars. Nine women. When it happened to you, didn't you want people to trust you?
I never told anybody. And
is that good
either? I
didn't think
if I was going to tell somebody, I would not have waited 38 years to tell it. That's what's mind-boggling. Why wait till now at an election to come forward and say, oh?
Okay, Frank, what you want to know is we got a bunch of conservatives here, and you want to know why we're going to vote for Roy Moore. My wife went to high school with Roy. She said in high school, Roy was a hard worker, an American success story, if you will. He always aimed for higher things. However, neither she nor I have ever voted for Roy up until now. And we intend to vote for Roy because of the opponent that's running. Right now, as far as I'm concerned, we've probably got two miserable candidates. In my opinion, we ought to go with a conservative. We ought to go with somebody that we know is going to vote conservative. And that's what I'm looking for.
Roy Moore is not a miserable man. This man has more integrity than you can find in the entire Congress right now. Don't fall for the George Soros assassination plan. The truth will come out. These women are all going to be proven, just like the 16 that went against President Trump, just right before the election.
What about the women who went against Bill Clinton?
The accusers of Clinton, everybody knows he's a... womanizer.
Well, people think the same thing about Roy Moore.
With Bill Clinton, they went to the courthouse and they filed papers. They didn't wait 40 years to do it. That's a huge difference than just going to the media only 6 weeks before an election.
So I got a question for you. We recruited, there are about 60 people who wanted to be in this group, and you guys ended up in it. Not a single African American is in this group. Why?
Welcome to Alabama, Democrat.
That's the best you can come up with.
I was here during during the civil rights era, we didn't have racial problems after the 80s because we went through it. When Obama was elected and he started his divisional rhetoric, race relations in Alabama went the rest of the way of the country.
The race relations in the state of Alabama is really not that bad.
But what does it say?
Why does it always come down to race? Why can't we just be Americans, Alabamians?
Because 97% of the African American community is going to vote for Doug Jones. Does that not concern you?
It does.
Yes, it does.
That concerns me greatly. It tells me that Roy Moore didn't do a very good job of getting out and campaigning.
So why aren't they voting Republican?
Because they listen to people, you know, that are that have influence over them.
If they've been so destroyed, why do they keep voting for them? Why won't they vote for your candidates?
Well, in my opinion, they'd be stupid.
I don't understand that.
If you vote for somebody that's making you worse and worse, do you call that smart or stupid?
Isn't a better question why African Americans wouldn't vote for him? I mean, like, why do they want immigrants coming over and taking the jobs that they could be having? You know, what do they believe? Do they believe a baby should be aborted at 9 months? I mean,
policy is everything, and if we don't stand for conservative policies, then we've lost anywhere.
Damn, that shit scared me.